So I'm joined here today by Sammie Spungold, who we're going to be talking today about your new play, because you're a writer and you're also a radio presenter, but also about your experience of being homelessness. It's a big issue in Brighton, as you know. So, I mean, first of all, should we just start off with your journey from being homeless on the streets, I think in Worthing and then Brighton, and then being a kind of creative genius in a way, writing plays, being a presenter. How did you make that leap? Because it's a tough leap, isn't it?
So where do you want me to start?
But how did you end up being on the streets?
OK, so I was living in Worthing at the time and I was working really hard. I was studying GMVQ Health and Social Care Advanced, GCSE Psychology. I was working as a care assistant. I had an evening job at Eater's Paradise, a kebab shop, and then my only morning off was looking after my friend's baby. And I'd just come out of foster care not long, and I was burning myself into the ground. I had no guidance. I had this mental breakdown, and then I found myself not working, not going to college, trying to get housing benefit, and my landlord refused. So I got evicted on my 18th birthday. I actually went to court, and I said to the judge, I was like, Worthing Council said they'll house me, so get me out of there as quick as you can.
Yeah.
So the judge gave me 2 weeks. I kept going back to the council every day, and on the final day, they said I'd made myself intentionally homeless.
Yeah.
So they refused to help. And that was it, 18 years old, literally just, and I was out on the street. Sofa surfed for a little bit, but people grass people up as well, you know. I was living on one sofa and then someone grassed them up for having me living there. Ridiculous. I wasn't paying them any money. So that was it. I found myself literally on the street.
And that encapsulates how someone... Because people often envisage how do people get on the street. Well, that's the story of how... Is that quite common, did you find?
Yeah, there's all sorts of different stories, you know, but it really can be that easy, you know.
Yeah.
People shouldn't be so judgmental, you know. Some of the abuse that I had whilst being on the street and people going, you know, shout and get a job at me and all sorts of stuff. It's just, it's really unnecessary.
Everyone... So if anyone ever asks, you know, how people end up in the street, I think that beautifully illustrates it there. So so the good news is you're now a radio presenter and a writer. So you've got a new play out, haven't you? So first of all, we'll start off with the play and then we can talk about your radio work.
Yeah, so I did a dissertation on whether... I'll shorten it, whether you can heal yourself through writing your traumatic story. And then through that, the big issue, they published my story about a success story because I used to sell their magazine.
Yeah.
And it was picked up by this director called Jane Gull.
Yeah.
She's won some awards for a recent film called My Feral Heart, won at Small Festival Awards. So they picked it up and it's been turned into a film. My story has inspired by true events, so we're hoping that will come out within the next year or two.
Yeah.
And alongside that, I'm going to rework on my play so that it can be shown at theatres and write my autobiographical book, which I'm working on at the moment.
That's a lot.
Yeah.
that's great. So, and you're also a radio presenter. So what got you interested in being a radio presenter?
So I was quite ill. I actually had hepatitis C, which I've now cleared. But while I was ill, I was finding myself quite bored being at home all the time. And this course came up in Bristol, where I'm now residing, in radio presenting. So I did this course. We test piloted Radio 19, first community station.
Yeah.
And then went from there. And so now I have my own show every Friday night, midnight till 2. It's called the Boomtime Radio Show.
Right.
Which covers all sorts of music.
How do people find that?
You can just Google Boomtime.
Boomtime.
Yeah.
Okay.
So it's Bristol, it goes out on the airwaves, but it's also online.
Yeah. Okay, and I should say you've been in Latest magazine before, but a few years ago. So how did that come about? You were you did some stunt work in America.
Yeah, so I was living here in Brighton at the time, and I went to Brighton College, did a course in acting there, an AS level in acting. And we had some work experience and I just wanted to do stunts. I thought that would be quite exciting. So someone got back to me and said, yeah, when are you coming to America? I'd had a car crash, I had some money coming, didn't want to just spunk it. I was like, brilliant. So I did that. My friend put me in touch with Bill from The Latest.
Yeah.
And he published it twice, my story about going there, and I kept a diary. And that was like the first thing I ever had published.
Great. That's great. So that's definitely the sort of thing Bill would do as well. So.
Yeah.
So that's really good news. So you're based in Bristol at the moment.
Yeah.
So good luck with the play. We can put some details online about that as well, and the radio presenting. So hopefully some Brighton viewers can catch tune in and listen to you on the radio.
Yeah, and then I work for a magazine there as well called 247 Magazine, which is online. So I do a lot of interviews with famous musicians, and then I type them up and they get published there.
Yeah.
So there's a few that I've got there online at the moment.
Yeah.
I've interviewed Shaggy, Miss Dynamite, Dawn Penn. I've been quite lucky, really, from going from where I was to where I am now.
It's a really good example of how you can come from being homeless on the street to a success like you are. I should also just briefly put a good word in for the Big Issue, because you saved up to buy a caravan from Big Issue proceedings. So that's a good reason why people should buy the Big Issue.
Yeah, and the Big Issue gives you hope, you know. When you're on the street, it's really hard. God, it makes me want to cry thinking about it. It's really hard. The amount of abuse that you get, and it's scary, especially being a girl, you know. And then the magazine, it gives you purpose. It gives you a reason to get up and go and do something, you know. You're no different from standing there selling the Times magazine or something, you know.
Yeah.
And I think people think that it's just a charity that we just get given the magazines. No, you have to buy them, you know.
Yeah.
They'll give you the first 10 for free, and then that's it. It gets you going, and it, you know, it teaches you to look after money and have this bit of self-worth, you know.
So, yeah. Really inspirational story, Sammy. So all the best in the future. We'll stay in touch. And thanks for coming on to the latest TV news.
Thank you for having me.
Thanks.